We're told to plot each decimal on the number line. First, we have 3.6 or 3 and 6 tenths. To begin, notice 3 and 6 tenths is between 3.0 and 4.0. Let's indicate this using inequalities. We'll say 3.6 or 3 and 6 tenths is greater than 3.0, which is really just 3, and less than 4.0, which is really 4. Because of this, we'll label 3 on the left side and 4 on the right side of the number line. And let's go ahead and label 3 as 3.0 and 4 as 4.0. And because we have 3 and 6 tenths, we'll now break up the number line from 3 to 4 into 10 equally sized parts, where each tick mark will represent 1 tenth. And now we'll count by 1 tenths from 3 to 4. We have 3 and 1 tenth, 3 and 2 tenths, 3 and 3 tenths, 3 and 4 tenths, and so on. I'm just staggering the values so they don't run together. Now we plot 3 and 6 tenths, which we can see is here on the number line. We make a close point, and let's go ahead and label it above. Next, we have 1.72, or 1 and 72 hundredths. To begin, notice this is between 1 and 70 hundredths and 1 and 80 hundredths. We'll say 1 and 72 hundredths is greater than 1 and 70 hundredths and less than 1 and 80 hundredths. 1.70 was equivalent to 1.7, or 1 and 7 tenths, and 1.80 was equivalent to 1.8, which is 1 and 8 tenths. But we'll go ahead and label the left side of the number line as 1.70, or 1 and 70 hundredths, and the right side as 1.80, or 1 and 80 hundredths. And now we'll break up this interval into 10 equally sized parts, where each tick mark will represent 1 hundredth. And now we'll count from 1 hundredths, from 1 and 70 hundredths to 1 and 80 hundredths. We have 1 and 71 hundredths, 1 and 72 hundredths, 1 and 73 hundredths, and so on. One and 72 hundredths is here on the number line. We make a close point. Let's go ahead and label it a little bit larger. I hope you found this helpful.